Edelman has understood that motor activity is mapped in the brain, and these maps tend to become bigger and join other maps or form bigger maps, and that a map of activity is also making a map of the activity of mapping, mm-hmm. so that they're very layered and mm-hmm. very complex mm-hmm. synaptic connections. And which he then says that the organism, using the fact that you make a map, and that you, as you make the map, the nervous system is re-entering the map that it's making to the map that it has made. So he's explaining a process of a delayed mechanism and a layering mechanism about what is happening, what is remembered as a map, and what is edited, and that you're in a very complex relationship between what has happened and what has been remembered and what is happening, mm-hmm. which makes a dimension. So that I began to understand that re-entry, as he described it, as a neural process, is a general organismic process, especially when you begin to think about how heat-regulating mechanisms have evolved. And going through all the different stages of the organism, producing a piece of work, heat from its metabolism, and then capturing its heat and stabilizing it so that you have a constant temperature mechanism, that is a process of re-entry. And so then you could see that how that happens with how I did something and remembered what I did, that means I've taken it back inside myself. What I've exteriorized, I begin to reflect on how I take it back by remembering it, and that is a kind of re-entry. Part of Edelman's thing was, though, that he said that re-entry organizes what has happened as a remembrance structure, which then tells you that memory is short-term and long-term, and that reentry is part and parcel of short-term memory, but that repeated enough times becomes long-term memory because it changes the actin formation in the synaptic junctions and makes hardwiring instead of temporary wiring, which then allows an exteriorization of what was learned and organized. Mm-hmm. So re-entry then tells you that reality is created after the event and not before. Mm-hmm.